start today's sessions we're going to start today's session with Professor Lazović. He's a professor in the Faculty of Architecture, University of Belgrade. His field of research is contemporary architecture in Serbia. He's published many times and he's done a theoretical research in this field. And also he's an architect practitioner. And he has been awarded for many of his works in the international and national competitions. And today he's going to talk about mutualization of contemporary Bulgarian architecture.
As you heard, I'm an architect working as professor of Berlin University, the Faculty of Architecture, who you don't know. This year I will try to talk about, I don't know, it's a good title, mutualization of contemporary Berlin architecture. This kind of phenomena were in focus last year, 2016, with Professor Djokic. We made some investigations about the last 20 years with the problem after the year zero. What's happening in the space, what's happening in town, what's happening in the Serbia, what is not normal in any notation, it's a world word. That was last year. It was really a large research, and we're talking about almost 2 hours about what's going on and about lex specialis and about illegal constructions and about 2,500,000 of houses done without permit, which makes a lot of housing fund in Serbia. This is an abstract for this year. It's a little long, maybe I can point some things here. Do you want to say something that nothing is so easy like it was before in understanding with what we are surrounded, what we understand, what we see, what we feel, what we have. This kind of topic is wider than architecture. Architecture is something which is around us, about 80-90% where we go, we are always surrounded by architecture, people in architecture. This is kind of notion that everything is a little bit shifted, different, looking maybe good, but not seem to be total sincere. Kinds of new local culture. It's spreading this kind of things which were just for the high class or for the kings or for the power for small, just kind of secrets and trusts for the small number of people. Now this kind of delusional set that I have some kind of by media epic proportions as I can think about that, say about that. I just wanted to try to by using this kind of things which I took from the quality of happenings in architecture and very near architecture in Belgrade, I wanted to show something about understanding and to show what is now using this kind of Potemkin Potemkin. In any way, we entered this kind of Potemkin villages, but in malpractice of using things in a proper way. And that's the most difficult thing is because the power is connected with this, inventions of lex specialis, which gives to some people advantage in everything, and for other people, you know, very lucky. We cannot say that there is really a market, anyway, market of labor, of many things open to everybody. I remember one lesson when Hans Ibelix were coming. He was the editor of A10, and he proposed that what are we talking about when we talk about actors? It's very old, about 10 years, no, 5 years, 7 years old, the title. And I just remember it to use it again here as a I asked myself, is there any architecture in Serbia, or a kind of illusion, which is just using some kind of raw power and in making profits? We don't know, we cannot enter this kind of a very black curtain, which is lex specialis. When you open this lex specialis, you have a lot of points. They are just painted black. You cannot see what's going on with the constitution and other laws. And that's what this relationship is concerned about. There's one kind of question. When will metro arrive? Many Bulgarians are already under the ground waiting for it. We have a town about 2 million inhabitants, and we have a lack of many things. I will not speak today about that because I was speaking last year about that. And this is kind of a joke that we are not doing something proper. Many things are not proper. This is a sign I found in it's circulating on the internet, but it's really photograph of my friend, architect. On Slavia, it's a lot of signs which means giving us the confusion about many things, not just as a title of Ivan Andrić novel, signs by the roadside, or our mistakes and illusions about many things. Just very illustrative thing that says you. This is the first group of architecture I want to show you. It's serious, big ideas and earnest or oxymoron, uncertain intentions for the architecture. This is the prospect of connection of a war island, Kriegsinsel in Belgrade. And the greenery which is present between two towns, old town on the right side and the right side, old town to the right, on the other side is a new Belgrade. And museum, closed museum of contemporary art, which is closed more than 12 years. They promised that they will open it in November, but we have a lot of these things. This is a very nice prospect, and facing is also, you can see on the right side, is Belgrade Fortress, which is also green and nice area here. Now you see what's going on. You see this ex-political center, CK, Central Committee of Communist Party, and you see the flag. It's a kind of a new flag, and this ideas about putting flags now. It's a new kind of ideas I haven't heard for years. So we heard about some crosses or other signs. This is really something new. Maybe our president saw it from his numerous voyages over the world. And on the left side, you can see this kind of crosses. And for assemblage, what can you say, renders about making this play, how it looks, how it will come, this paisage landscape of joint of old and the new town, and third part of it is nature. It's a lot of steel, a lot of nature, not abused. And this kind of proposition is always coming not from the bottom, it's coming from the top. You will see some experiences here about some countries with this super flex and flex pole. It's kind of a championship for the biggest, longest flag in the world. You see Brasilia here. New town of Brasilia, if you see the flag pole of, I think it's Tajikistan, it's very big. You see some Jubilee Garden in London, it's a small, pretty small American, USA flag, it's pretty small. This is, I think, the largest, it's about, I don't know, 35 to 70 meters. If it fall like this in Saudi Arabia, it would make us provocate some problems. And this is very small flag made in Kusumia. This flag was mounted, it was cost about 100 euros. That was the inhabitants of this place made and make some sign of this flag that it's concerning Serbia here. And the other you can see other Serbia. This proposition is not so competitive, it's about 120 meters, but you see Saudi Arabia 170, 165, 162, and Turkmenistan 133. Here is something that you see that the flag pole is 120 meters, and have this X house of Central Committee is 141 meters. That's kind of a rare situation about this. But the travel is not coming alone, never coming together with some other things. This is the second appear of a young girl coming from Denmark with his ideas he brought in his several books. First was Living in the Heights, I think. About meeting the people, recognition and society. He was called him to come, his first time was before 7-8 years, and the second time is now, proposing this beautiful natural place, where he speaks in so here, and this joint of three different things, like new world and nature, proposed seven zones, something which is very old. As the modernists proposed this kind of zones, there's some zone for music, or zone for nature, it's stupidity, zone of walking, of moving. This kind of London Eye joint here. Everything what they saw in the road, they said to accurate this space, and that was proposition of this Harvard and Cambridge young fellows of this young girls company, whom we visited before, I think 10 years ago in his office. And the explanation what will happen about these zones. And they wrote, of course, that that it will be like a Central Park in Europe, or it will be a Central Park in it will be a park of work in Moscow. This is again stupidity, par excellence stupidity, because it can be measured when these scales are different. And you see some renders also. This looks like a work of student from second or third year, not so good. What is interesting here is the basic idea of EML. I would say what principles, but the principles are just said. People and public space are priorities in urban planning rather than a monumental representation of political power of an individual, a ruling or a party. That what is doing is totally opposite of that what is written. But if you have all media supporting this and simple people, they just believe it. So, the same third thing I will mention here after Flag. Polls, this park, young girl. I mentioned some competitions, so you say that the people have some games to, architects have some little games to play. And you see this again, the Palace of Serbia, that's excellent government of Yugoslavia. It's a very nice building, a beautiful building here. And they proposed to make Philharmonic. And Zubin Mehta, who is going to be retired, he's retired with a lot of money. Because he started his career here. And this is Palace of Communists here, ex-Palace of Communists, Central Committee, this is government, and this was the central part of ex-power of Yugoslavia and of socialism, like communism and socialism. And we have these projects, done by our two colleagues. What was the problem with this? Is these four skyscrapers introduced in this green area. That's the first thing. As we give something for culture, we should give something to our money. That's the first thing. And the second is that this is not so much original. From some angles, original work, it looks pretty same as the opera in Austin. If we say that the principles are the same, put the new building of culture, near riverside, waterfront, it's a very good idea just to rebalance the center. but there are some problems with this. The flag was expensive, about 2-3 million euros, and Philharmonic is about 50 million. This is sum of 60-70 million, which is waiting the National Museum of Art, National Museum of Art. Not this one, I show you the other one. For 14-15 years, he's totally abandoned, and people don't know what is inside yet. Is he closed because there is no money, or is he closed because everything was stolen from him? There's a lot of questions. When we start to talk about architecture, a lot of questions are coming. That's the first fourth thing I show here. That's a kind of proposition of a president also is very responsible around him about making new museum and monumental sculptures of Nemanjić dynasty instead of bombed headquarters of architect Nikola Dobrović, and interior works were made by Croatian architect Nemanjić. And this is also talks about it, talks. You can see how it looks nicely today, but also our government helped this house to look even better, and she cut these pieces in two, and now it will be done. What I underline here, that the bombing transformed this Generalstab, this headquarters, in a sort of natural monument in Belgrade, which is said by one thinker, Mazzucchelli. Making some, creating some symbolic space of confrontation and conflict between the Serbian people and the international community. Once this kind of ruins became a kind of a semantic monument already. it's kind of a metaphorical urban scar which starts bleeding again on the special occasions like it was of liberation, possible permission, liberation 2008. This is founder, it's not just the people are playing history, this is not just the founder of Serbian king family in the 17th centuries. There were some kings before, but they are most important. And the ex-minister of justice said that priorities are big in to put memorial complex of Stefan Nemanja, and it's task of national importance. It's kind of again coming from top. This is a sculpture from one town from Serbia. I don't know where, but in Belgrade we still don't come. This is something what was done nearly by looking for this airplane who is flying between Europe, America, United States and Russia, an important emperor, Russian emperor, Nicholas II, and made sculpture in front of the government, the new building, not really new, but this is the government building of Serbia. On the very nice place. I found one photograph where we can see that dear Miki and dear Georgie are very same. They were dressed in a German military suits. Before that, they were allies of Germany before the Second World War, and then something changed. It seemed in this photography, we witnessed that everything is was totally different. I just find some little. Again, we are coming to this fifth idea about despot. Despot is a ruler, but we translate despot. It's kind of rigorous ruler, autocracy ruler. And after the Rusyn Battle of Kosovo, he moved to this lower town of Belgrade, that was a metropole, and the other kings were here. And they propose now to make this kind of scenographic, maybe sound, light and sound or something, I don't know, one town, where we can learn history, not in museums, not in schools, but we can look and have how this desperate town is looking. Maybe he will not be so much the same. They will have some kind of, they'll change something once. But this is the last nice, beautiful space in Belgrade, where we can have a combination of natural and beautiful things. And this is a joke, one joke, circulating on internet. For all these examples, nobody knows they will be done or not. But they're used in this kind of consciousness of people by media. And, maybe in the same way as the Pokemon is searching for architecture. This is how this looks like, this despot of town. Who was in Skopje, in this beautiful town, with beautiful people, he can find what happened in the last 10 years or 15 years with Kosovo, with this bridge of artists, full of sculptures, even the Petr Perličko, famous Yugoslav and Macedonian actor is posed here, and many other academician poets, and maybe some stolen from Greek, there's also from Greek and other cultures, stones, historical monuments. And this is kind of a freshly constructed identity, and we are afraid that everything is going in. Could go in this direction. You can see here the name, I will not speak about Skopje, okay, but you see that Alexander Makedonsky, his father, Philip, and other Cyril and Methodi are here. They are okay, they are really spending time. And the cross, up and the flag, and a lot of sculptures. I never saw in my life such. Kind of cast, even the lions and the girls young and the muses, Ateneo, are present here. The other, how fresh is this and how much is working? I got a message from Paul, but I will make some abbreviation and then we will lose my time totally, about quarrel between Kusturica and owner of Rapinj region in Belgrade, because Kusturica is, here you go to court, because Mitrovic, that Mitrovic used his idea about underground and made this reality show using some kind of his scenography. It means that we are operating about not just about semantic things, not just many other things like curses or making this kind of simulacrum in reality. This is two towns. Kusturica wanted to make Fire of Five. He got some very big European awards for this. You can see this in Visegrad. Andrisgrad, combination of Oriental and Austro-Hungarian housing, but maybe this year, last year, before 5 years. And this is a village. It looks like Bavarian village when you go inside. It's said that this is a very national, but I don't see this again. But on the other hand, he's making some kind of generating university education, works, opening the professions in this town for this Mechelmik or Kunstendorf, his ski school and many other things. The second bunch of ideas is about small and big plates. They are not so much interesting. I just passed. This is a flower square in Belgrade. The competition was before, I don't know, 20 or 30 years. They finished now, but on a very cool way, I can say, making this plateau for renting area. So, and this is very old tree with this construction on the oldest tree in Belgrade. And it was done a little bit up young, relatively young architects. And it's looking like this. In construct square for many years in the after colonies, very less of squares were made. I can say something new. This is the home of National Library and moved by the fire of the Second World War and given to Boris Podreka to make some kind of landscape park as a memory because there's some conditions of protection that you cannot build anymore because all the main documents what Serbia had disappeared in this very old documents, everything, all history, almost all history. What was saved was Vienna, Dresden and Istanbul, I think, in these archives, maybe more. And this is something I'm not sure they promised before 5-6 years they would make international competition, but they just give to Podreka to exercise his. This is another thing in Vasina, academic square in the very middle of the town center. He's making this kind of big diagram, making this from one. Traffic square, we exchanging to one pedestrian and giving back park and square in there. But it's kind of these lines going like this. I'm not sure that it's commenting about that culture and our past and our future. Here are the ruins of many ruins of the Roman Empire. From the 2nd or 4th century of my Romans, like Flavia Regia, and there's a terrace all around here, the terrace and the graves. And this is like you can see in Belgrade, this is under the earth. Now we don't have more, we have just two places because everything is ruined. This faculty where Petar Bojanić was, you were studying. You were a student of this faculty, huh? Faculty of Philosophy. And you see how much all things are under the earth, buried here. And some are visible here. And this is from this park, around the terms. And these locations which disappear, 80% are definitely, there is a whole Roman town under the city that was by new buildings were totally damaged, don't exist anymore, or just, but no one say nothing. When they excavated the ground, like here, where the tram is going around, Belgrade Fortress, I saw a lot of these sarcophagus trees and sarcophagus and the walls, and they just put up on it very fastly to finish this and to put it back. And this is the one on the biggest Lake Slavia in Belgrade. This is the Radiska Terasa, this kind of dream to finish in the real center, in the center of center, finish some spaces and places to look warmer, and several ideas a lot of ideas were done, but nothing was just promises or something. Like this is one architect, Regic, and this is idea of a young couple, Šišović and her husband. This is Dobrović works now about Teraska Terasa, and this is kind of collage of one building going, making this breakthrough. Because Bogdan Vukanović and other architects said that before 57 years, from this point of Terazije, or Balanska, or you can translate Balanska, we can see River Sava and River Dunaj. And this is an idea about this terrace, nice idea. But these ideas were abandoned, all this. And this is all competitionized also by our colleagues, how to make a very square in the air on glass. I think I like this idea. But nothing, it was two competitions, and these participants made the same competition work in 87 or in 95. They just didn't want to change any idea about it. Now we are about cultural illusions and bogus phantom propositions. Let me see what's going here. This is something could be very real. This is a Chinese embassy under bombing. And this new cultural center on New Belgrade, I think it will be done. I believe indeed that China has a force and a word when it was given to make this. This I don't believe. We have Nikola Tesla, who spent 16 hours in Belgrade in his whole life. We have a beautiful museum because he inherited a lot of things. And we put in one building of 300 square meters. But this kind of building should be given back to the owners and the owners. And somebody proposed some kind of phantom project of 30,000. 30,000 square meters on this beautiful location on Dočo, but all other things are already given to some controversial businessmen. If this should be done, we'd be very glad to have a Kroc Tesla on 30,000 square meters, but it looks sick. This is the place, this house, this building is going to be just disappearing, and this kind of work nobody will take care of. About some realizations, not about some illusions and dreams, we can start from many things I mentioned before. Slavia, we have seen the years of modernization, not just New Belgrade, but also this was photo made for, I think, some kind of Universiada or sportive. And then after it was an avia company hotel with the sculpture of Dmitrij Tulcevic, who was first social democratic people in Serbia, very important figure. But now he's moved from this. He had also a grave. His grave was put in after the Second World War. Here he had his bones under this sculpture. But this is kind of an island where there are a lot of cars, vehicles are going from the ground. And they proposed to make, the Arabians proposed to make a musical singing fountain. Okay. You can see he's moved from here. I don't know where is the sculpture. His remains are some proper place. And this is a Bioskop Slavia, who was done by McKenzie and other people who were helping develop knowledge in Belgrade. And it was a very good art school here. It disappeared in 1993. You can see this proposition for this part of Slavia. It's a very big square. And this is National Bank of Yugoslavia. I don't know if it's inherited or not, or used partly. It was the capital of Yugoslavia. And competitions, again, they proposed to make competitions and about Slavia, everything is going around, and you see the old architects also started to go around, and some interesting ideas were presented here, because this is like something which was playing dancing fountain. It was not a singing fountain. This proposition was a dancing. And they mixed all this. They didn't receive any problem. They didn't solve any problem about pedestrians, about cars, but they put fountain. Okay. They put a beautiful fountain. Nobody knows how much it costs, about 200,000 you can buy Alibaba, or I don't know, or 2 or 3 million euro, which they gave this fountain, what is a real price. And if you want to see, I don't know if it's possible, there is no sound. But you can see how it's working. In Tajikistan, Uzbekistan, Kazakhstan, you have also kind of Abu Dhabi, you have also kind of these mountains. This one was hacked and speaking to telling people good morning to kitchen, good night Serbia. It became a battlefield. And this is very nice, joined by music of Sinan Sakic, but I don't have any conditions, you cannot hear how it is looked at. It's turbo folk, very strong turbo folk. My friend, artist, was also architect, but he was a very good artist in life. Dragan Papic, who made the indoor museum in Belgrade, proposed, this is his artifacts, he's collecting and making some conceptual things. He proposed that we can use this fountain to stop the fire on this London skyscraper. This was his conceptual idea. He stopped breaking dark for, I think, 10 or 12 years, but I found that this is very nice. I found it on the internet. But if we can make some discretion, this digression, we can put ourselves some questions. What happened? How much? They were told it was safe. Disaster in 50 minutes. How is it possible for such a thing to happen? For me, it was really, really something new. And the really cause of this thing was that they didn't want to spend additional £300,000 to put proper insulation, which is not burning, because they don't like to have these people here. They don't like to have these houses here. They try to just mask the poverty and to dislocate them from Chelsea, Kent. This is West Kensington, very the wealthiest municipalities of the world. if something happened like this, I'm totally confused. What will happen tomorrow in this proper world of our British architects? This is our also Serbian jokes about Nikola Tesla. This was proposition, a new proposition, how to make Tesla Tower, to put this kind of lightings from there, to put there a center after, and then you put a finger and leg, and then you go inside. And this is also a political thing, that somebody proposed this complex of Tesla City, using this, abusing this name of Tesla, mega complex of 2,000 to 2 million square meters, about 100,000 people who can live. And this is idea of one of ideas of here, because this Karas was a criminal here, and then now he asked the president to come back and to invest, and he said, okay, you can come. And then he asked for this, and he asked to buy some kind of PKB agricultural, old agricultural, be very big company, but it didn't happen. And it's kind of, how I say, political and the money having nothing with architecture. This is his project in Minsk. It's larger, it's a kind of 3 million square meters with a lot of skyscrapers, and you can see the two companies were making this, one French were, one British company making this new city. After that, our official said, okay, we shall make competition. And they changed the purpose of water use land in 1914. Say, okay, you can build here. I don't know, it's so much long, it's about 8, 9, 10 kilometers long. You know, this is the first price of our friends. For faculty, they made this proposition, not so big now, but it will be, but nobody knows the destiny of this. I had a little, my assistant made this competition, I was involved a little bit, but I don't know. It is, how I say, too much to have such new towns. It's a long time for that. But they proposed it. And the last, this is kind of shopping malls, so like alien coming from the Orson Welles drama, Radio Drama. And I think I showed this slide about 1, 2, 3. This is kind of shopping mall, and on the roof there's a sport ground, football ground, and different in the center of the town. And this is new property. This is outside of town, but all others are inside. This one is made in one central street of Knez Miloš, where a lot of embassies here. You can see how if you look, this is leading to the center of town. I'm sorry, that's my home finish. And the Hotel Hilton also is coming. The worst thing, as I can see, it's a 1,600,000 shopping mall made in the very, very center, in a protected culture monumental center of the town. On the excavations were made of Roman town. How many floors underground? All houses around, which are last, and the oldest houses we don't have because of this wars, oldest house in 200 years. And this is 160 or 150. They are totally going to be demolished. This is one idea with the hotel and shopping mall and combination can be very big garage. This is kind of a new mood. And you can see some very nice from the beginning of the 20th century. It's a Hungarian tiles, green tiles house from one page. And you can see this monster coming up. The last past this, you know, well, it's here, it's very common thing, it's out of there a bit, but it's not the end, because I didn't find there's a lot of the carbon. This is from a tsunami, a lot of rock. And on the top of this cake is this 140,000 square meters, made under the name Bergen Waterfront Gallery, shopping, giant shopping mall, and connected with this tower, and connected with many things you will see now. This was done from the Bergen of the Water, and nobody likes them. But they are doing that, we don't know who is the owner. Somebody said that things connected with Arabs anymore, who started to build that. You don't know who is the owner, who will make profits, nothing. And this is all the Tram Bridge, and because it's very near this part of the new houses, they have to change it, because you cannot sell very expensive square meters with this kind of total bridge in parts. Okay, this house is very waterfront, if you like. From every street, from Old Town, you can see this is flanking the Liber view. And I ask you, can you say what of these examples are buried on the water? Has no significant, no character enough, and it's very similar to all these profit towns making in La Paz, maybe in Singapore, this kind of tricks made like an American knight is president. I had a lot of these examples, but it looks like 20s or 30s, but here you see that it's kind of a combination of voisinage with this kind of toys. I don't have enough time, but during I had an idea to write about this. There was some interview came about one very famous filmmaker. The title of this interview is Life in the Roof of Absolute Lies. I was shocked about this, and I was shocked about many things. It is very recent interview. He's retired, or I can say if you can retire. This is one of the best our movie directors and theater directors. And I will show you some very, very small sentences just to try to explicate the thing. He called it landscape after cultural cataclysm. Those who live from culture will have only two options, either to start creating in the name of glory, or the leader, or to die of starvation. I do not accept brainwashing, terror of doubling dress and pornography on TV channels. Because culture alone can overcome this base, unscrupulous gang. When you look at the cartoon of Duško Petričić, you remain stunned by simple trap that is offered on an ordinary piece of paper. That trap cannot destroy it even with a million worst treats, curses, lies. We entered a completely new, so far unknown type of reality in the sphere of absolute lies. It's a second, it's like a title. All is in the service of deception. There's something that is certainly not a lie, and that is poetry. In art, in the poetic expression, in the broader sense of the word, the lie is immediately recognized and annihilated. And the truth feels it does not have to be proven. And that's why art is so precious and rare. These sentences give some hope and some faith what to do. Because it's a very depressive interview and very real, I can say. Maybe it's not real. We are talking, are the things real? Is architecture real? I don't know. He was talking also about some making a desert kind of this is the beginning of Gilbert, but he was mentioning the Gobi Desert. For a long time, there's another interview 3 months before, I found that also, for a long time, since 87, with a small break, we are in one long poem. Poem is an absolute lie. But pornography is not without audience, and people were somehow a bit complacent. All of this has led us to a society dominated by absolute lies, through the media, falsified diplomas, undeserved jobs, and the fight against lies with proclaimed and anti-state. I brought instead to give something else. I wanted to finish with the song of Leonard Cohen, but it's a very hard song, and I don't want to do it, about wrong connotation. I just find 3 cartoons about our now president. He was prime minister, making this scene in the sky, helping by these masked people, and his mayor, his ruining Belgrade, that little, his name is Mal, means little mayor can do, and these colors can find also this kind of palaces. There you, this kind of a very obvious architect, finished 3 years of Koraksic. He's 83-84, he still has good wit and making this kind of caricatures. And this one can express that this very good. If I remember the once when I met George Podreka very, many years ago, he said life is guided in architecture. I just we were so much towards architecture, we didn't see where is architecture, where is life. And there is an art in architecture, then architects lives. If, however, there is not, but only politics, money, interest, and profits change for architecture to survive is very slim. There are at least 8 ways to see, feel, know, find, guess what architecture is about, we will talk about it. And ultimately, what can architectural practice teach us about the society we live in? Well, this was an example of Vega. Sorry, I'm not feeling good. I took maybe too much time.